Hi peeps. So small updates today. Today is Wednesday, I think. Let me look on my computer. Yeah, looks like it's today, Wednesday. My brain's all frizzled. I went to bed last night around 2, which is my normal time, but I was so tired I totally spaced on the day this morning. Anyways, so yesterday Dixie was officially sold to Leah. She is now a proud owner of It's a Dixie, which is Dixie's show name. She can change it, but that's what I always called her. Extremely happy. She's been working with that pony since the beginning of August, I believe, or beginning of September, all the way until yesterday. I mean, coming out every day, cleaning stalls, giving water, grooming, walking, lunging, riding. We haven't had the best weather this winter for her to ride, so she worked her ass off for this pony. So yesterday cut me off. Someone called me. How dare they? So I just canceled it. Anyways, so where was I? Oh yeah, so yesterday she officially became the owner of Dixie. So Dixie will be leaving here either Saturday or Monday to go to the new boarding facility. I will miss the little pony deeply. Or horse. She's a horse Annie. she's an Icelandic horse pony cross, so it's kind of like she can fall in either category. I call her a pony. But I'm gonna miss her dearly. She is a sweet little thing, but I am happy she finally found her person. Remember, we rescued Dixie from the feedlot, from the slaughter truck. And she was never really a keep. You know, I said I would keep her for life if I couldn't find her a new home. I didn't want to just sell her off to anyone. Leah and her have this really nice bond. She goes right up to Leah. Leah can, you know, say, hi, Dixie, and Dixie will come up from the pasture to her, where if I go and try to get Dixie, she runs the other way. Except for the other day when she got out, she actually came to me. So Leah has actually given this little pony some confidence that someone can love her without, you know, abuse and stuff like that. So it's very important to me that they both found each other, and I believe that they will have a very long, happy relationship. I did my part. I made the pony safe. You know, she's green broke, but she is safe, and that's what I do. I try to make sure that when I train a horse, they are safe for any person. So I am very happy and proud that I'm able to resettle one more horse to a forever home. Knock on wood. That they will forever be together. So, bittersweet moment. She found a new owner. I will post a couple of clips here of them running around the yard. Nothing special. They're just, you know, doing their thing. Also, we are picking up the new horse trailer on Friday evening. Excited about that. It's my first gooseneck trailer, so I'm kind of nervous, but not really. So we will see. That's all the updates for now. I am in the process of getting stuff for the trailer, like wheel chucks and a trailer aid for changing the spare, a backup camera to put onto the trailer to hitch it up, because my truck has a tailgate camera, but it doesn't help me when I'm backing up to a gooseneck, because I don't have it right there on the top of the window. So I ordered my husband's texting me, so I ordered a camera to stick on the gooseneck so that when I back it up to the truck I can see what I'm doing, because it's gonna be totally new for me. And first aid kit for the horse, which I will be doing box openings with everything that I get in the mail. I also ordered a couple more magic brushes because I'm totally in love with the one that I have. So I decided to buy Fancy her own set and buy Sassy another one, smaller one for her legs. I might actually end up getting rid of every other brush that I have just because these magic brushes are so awesome. So I might actually end up just selling the other brushes. I'll keep my really nice body brushes for the sleeking of their fur and the hair brushes and stuff like that, but like the really hard brushes, I don't really use them anymore just because of the new magic brush. I mean, it's that crazy. Let me think. That's about it. I mean, that's all the updates that I have right now. Everything's really hectic. So yeah, there we go. Oh, and so the big update that I was gonna tell you guys about, I don't really want to say anything, but everyone's slowly finding out as it is. We are in the process of moving back to Colorado Springs. So yay, back to Colorado. I miss Colorado so much. Being in New York for the last 5 years has been 5 years way too long. So that does unfortunately mean that the sheep, Dottie and Coconut, will be sold. They are going to a therapeutic center that does things for people. And the emu eggs that I'm incubating, they will be sold, if they hatch, they will be sold to a person down by New York City who wants them. So it's kind of bummy, you know. I mean, I slowly was starting to get the barn and the farm up and everything, but unfortunately, as things happened, you know, we need to go where we're more comfortable. And Colorado has always been home to me. You know, I'm from Germany, and Colorado just seems a lot more European than New York does, actually. Weather-wise, New York sucks. Colorado is a lot more even out, and I need the sun. I'm literally getting sick here in New York so often that it's not beneficial to me at all. There's not enough vitamin D year round for me, and I need the vitamin D. I'm basically like a freaking reptile. You know, I'm like a lizard. I need the sun at least 360 days out of the year where I can go 5 days without. But here, it's literally, I'm lucky if I get 100 days of sun, and I've been getting sick. I haven't been feeling good. And for my health, it's beneficial just to go back to Colorado. So, for any of my suburbs that are in Colorado, in the Colorado Springs area, if you want to take lessons from me when I get back, I am more than happy to give you guys lessons in eventing and anything else that you need help on. So just putting it out there. I am in a process of updating my website, so I'll post a link in my next video. I still got some smaller things to do, but like I said, we're moving back to Colorado. That's why we sold the 3-horse trailer to get to 2-horse, because it has a sleeping quarter in the front. And that's why everything's been kind of awkward lately with the vlogs, you know, with me saying I don't want to say anything. But basically, I'm putting it out there for you guys now. I keep hearing a weird noise. We are moving back to Colorado. Hopefully, if we can get our house here sold in time, me and my husband will move together around June to Colorado. If not, I am staying here in the house until the house sells. Yeah, not to thrill them on that, but we can't abandon the house. So I will stay here with the horses until this house sells, and then I will follow suit to my husband, and I'll give them plenty of time to find another place for us to live. We're not sure if we're going to live in town and board the horses out, or if we're gonna find a house with land. Now, if we do end up finding a house in town without land, I already have a place where I'm putting my horses, so I'm not too worried about it. I just, you know, I've been doing self-care, taking care of my own horses for the better of a decade. And I just don't like anyone else messing with my horses. So it will be self-care, but they're not going to be in my backyard, which is extremely hard for me because I haven't done off-property boarding in over 10 years. So it's going to be another getting back into the habit of letting the horses go and just releasing the reins, which I can't do because it's so hard. So we are hoping that when we're moving back, that we'll be able to find a place that has land that where we can put the horses on our property. Because either way, I'm going to be ending up paying for hay. So there you go. Okay, so this vlog has been going way too much the other way. I was just going to update you guys with Dixie, but anyways, go ahead and like and subscribe down below if you have any questions or concerns. I don't know why I say concerns, but if you have any questions or whatever, go ahead and leave them in the comment down below. I will answer them as quickly as possible. If you're in Colorado, let me know. Be like, hey, I'm from Colorado. I'm here. I would love to find someone to ride with. I do plan on going to cross country courses every other weekend, if that, to go schooling. So I love to take people with me and ride with them just to, get the horses settled and going and stuff like that. So, anyways, I'll talk to you guys later. Remember, helmets on, heels down, and be safe out there, guys. And I will talk to you guys in the next video. Bye.